large caps leading the way like they have for so long right now.
Yeah.
Does that trend continue this year?
Well, we think there are going to be a lot of large cap companies that will benefit this year. And, you know, our little group's up about 5.9% year to date on entrepreneurial large caps. But we think those indices that are heavyweight, Microsoft and Apple, will suffer relative to others. So last year, Microsoft and Apple, representing about 16.6% of the Russell 1000 growth, kind of drove much of the market. We think this year it's U.S. small caps, non-U.S. small caps. U.S. small caps have been on a tear since October, since we met last October. They've been up 16%. Non-U.S. small caps leader last month, 5.3%. Year-to-date, our entrepreneurial small caps are up about 3.8%.
So I buy that because we watched those small caps play catch-up at the end of last year. But then to start this year, they're starting to falter yet again.
Yeah.
What's going on? What does it need? What does the market need to see from small caps to get them to really start that trend higher?
Well, you know, again, I mean, we're not seeing it in the entrepreneurial space, right? We're seeing, you know, strong growth. I mean, they're up almost 4% for non-U.S. They're up above almost 5% for U.S. small caps. So I think there's certain pockets that haven't caught up for the last 3 years. We're seeing companies like that are off 50, 60, 70% for the last 3 years, non-U.S. And U.S., you know, they're still coming back. You know, many companies are still 20% below their all-time highs, even though the revenues and the profits are there.
All right. Is it geographically focused small caps elsewhere outside the U.S., or is it more industry focused? Is it tech, banks, biotech?
Well, I mean, we're seeing across all areas. So we're seeing Swedish tech companies that are way up about 40% year to date. In some cases, we're seeing consumer discretionary. We haven't seen this in a while. UK companies. We're seeing, of course, China. China's been very strong year to date. I mean, coming out of the gate, you know, China's been the strongest country. It's up around 4%. But we're seeing global growth, a lot of valuation plays, and a lot of high growth. So it's a dual market.